We analyzed it with respect to the definition and we explained the construction. Okay, so I'm just redefining the things again. So what is the objective of PMMC instrument, or what is the working principle of PMMC instrument? So as per the it works on the principle of Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. What does the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction says? A current carrying conductor is placed in the presence of a magnetic field. Okay, it will experience certain amount of force. Okay, that's what the thing happened. So if we see the structure here, I will show the, I just downloaded an animation. I will show that. So this is the thing. So this is the permanent magnet structure. Okay, so here in this working animation, he analyzed with respect to an U-shape type permanent magnet. So this is a U-shape permanent magnet. In normal point of view, this is in a general point of view, we call this as a horseshoe magnet. Just in an observation point of view, I'm saying the term. Most of the, we can't say most of the meters, they will use the same type of magnet and all. But the thing here, what's happening means, so this is a type of magnetic structure, and this represents the North Pole and this represents the South Pole. Okay, so in between, this magnet will create a magnetic lines of poles and this magnet will create a magnetic flux. Okay, so in the presence of magnetic flux, what it did means I placed the vertical conductor. So this is nothing but our spindle. See, on the screen there is a vertical conductor in the presence of the in between this magnet there is a vertical conductor that is nothing but our spindle. Okay, so on the spindle I placed an aluminium former, rectangular aluminium former. So this is a rectangular aluminium former. On the rectangular aluminium former, what we did, we just winded the coil with an thin hair copper segment is winded as a coil on this particular aluminium former. Okay, so next, how we connected the needle, we will see how the needle is connected. Okay, so this is nothing but the springs. Two springs are you already discussed in the previous class. Okay, the controlling torque is achieved with respect to spring control. Mostly controlling torque is achieved with respect to two type of control. One is spring control and second one is gravity control. So this is how the control spring controlling torque is achieved in permanent magnet moving coil instrument. A spring control is utilized. So this is one spring is connected here on the top of the vertical conductor, a spindle. This vertical conductor is nothing but spindle. So the, and this is nothing but another spring. The two types of springs are used to create the controlling torque. Okay, and next, this is the needle. See, there is a black color segment. Most of the times, if we see in our laboratory, so the needle is in the form of aluminium pointer. So this is the needle. Okay, see how the needle is connected. So the needle is connected to the vertical conductor with the help of the pivot and jewel. Pivot is nothing but a screw. With respect to the jewel bearing, we connected the needle here. We connected the needle here. Okay. And next, this is the direction of the deflection torque. Okay, this is the direction of deflection torque. That means this is a magnet, North Pole and South Pole. Magnetic lines of poles are flowing from North Pole to South Pole. This is a magnet. Magnetic lines of poles are flowing from North Pole to South Pole. In the presence of this particular magnet, we placed the conductor. We placed this conductor. And the conductor is having the aluminium, rectangular aluminium former. On this particular rectangular aluminium former, we placed the coil, copper coil, and we connected the supply to this coil. We connected the supply to this coil. So this coil is nothing but having certain amount of current. This coil is a current carrying conductor in the presence of magnetic field. It will experience certain amount of force or torque and it will rotate. At what particular direction it will rotate? It will rotate in a clockwise direction in this manner. I have shown on the screen in a red mark. So this is the direction of the pointer rotation, and that is how the deflection torque is exercised. Okay, so in counter to this particular deflection torque, what will happen in counter to the deflection torque? The controlling torque is exercised. How the controlling torque is exercised? Controlling torque is exercised. So how the controlling torque is exercised? Controlling torque is exercised with the help of two particular springs. with the help of two particular springs, controlling torque is exercised. Okay. What are the errors present in PMM's instrument? Error. What is an error? The error is nothing but the difference between actual value with respect to the absolute value. So that creates an error. Okay. So how does this error happens in PMMC instrument? So errors mostly happens in PMMC instrument because of aging and temperature effects of instruments. So this is one of the important concept. So in a theoretical point of view also, we will get some type of bits in competitive exams. How the error occurs in a PMMC instrument with respect to the effect of temperature and even with respect to the effect of aging. Aging in the sense, if we use the same instrument for a specific period of time, continuous period of time, the instrument will get aged and they are used to cause error. So what are the parameters involved in this particular aging? What means, what are the main parts involved in the errors of PMMC instruments? Means magnets. Okay, so while with respect magnets, springs, moving coil, so these are the main main parts which causes with respect to error: magnets, springs, and moving coils and all. So which these are the things causes error. So how these things will cause an error? How magnet will cause, how the magnetic system, we are saying that for in a instrument of PMMC, permanent magnet moving coil, that too we are using a permanent magnet of alkaline and alkali material, which creates a strong magnetic field. Even though it is creating a strong magnetic field, how does that create an error? Means because of the continuous use of this particular magnet, permanent magnet, this causes a certain amount type of a heat and vibration in the magnet in the instrument, that reduces the lifespan of the magnet. That means that reduces the lifespan of the permanent magnet. Okay, so that means how does this particular lifespan is reduced? Means, so whenever the permanent magnet is continuously used a particular specific period of time, it will expose to heat, it will expose to vibration. Okay, so that creates the magnet to lose its property of attraction and repulsion. So whenever the property of attraction and repulsion is losing with respect to the magnet, okay, the efficiency and efficacy of the magnet is continuously reducing. So that's the issue. Okay, second thing is springs. So how the springs will get impact with respect to the error? Means due to the continuous deflection. Okay, so while continuously using the instrument for a period of time, if we use the instrument for a period of time, okay, due to the deflection on and deflection off of this particular instrument, so there used to be the springs gets weakened with respect to the effect of temperature. Okay, so if we on an average in an instrument, around 0.04% of spring efficiency is getting depleted for a specific period of time. So and third thing is moving coil. So this is one of the main instrument of the this is one of the main part of PMMC instrument. So how does this thing impacts with respect to the error? How does the PMMC instrument moving coil is affected with respect to the error? Means, so the error point of view, if you see the error segmentation, so the coil is having certain range if we connected with respect to the shunt or if we connected with respect to the series. So how does the range occurs, mean how does the error occurs? Means with respect to the change in coil resistance due to continuous flow of current or due to continuous change with respect to the resistance. So the coil copper wire is having a particular property, even it is a high resistance property or low resistance property. So this get affected with respect to the continuous change of series resistance and shunt resistance. So due to rapid change with respect to the resistance point of view, the moving coil will experience an effect in temperature. Okay, moving coil will create an effect in temperature, and that reduces the efficiency of the working instrument. Okay, so how does the errors created in PMMC instrument? Errors in PMMC instrument is created due to temperature and aging effect. First, the most important parameter is temperature, vibration, aging. So these are all one of the parameters affects the efficiency and that creates the error of the PMMC instrument. So with respect to this effects like temperature, vibration and aging, so what are the instruments will get the faulted means magnets, springs and moving coil. So this thing will have help because of the vibration and heat. Okay, the lifespan of the magnet is getting reduced. That means magnetism properties is reducing. The treatment of magnetism property is getting reduced and the attraction and repulsion is quite weakened, and that creates the decrease in the deflection of the coil. That is the thing happened with respect to the magnet. And second thing is springs. Because of this particular heat and vibration, the springs will get sagged with respect to the effect. Even though there is a small value of current, they will get rapidly deflected because of the thing. So when there is a weakening of the spring, controlling torque is affected and the total deflection of the instrument is getting affected. And last thing is moving coil. So due to the rapid extension of resistances, so if we extend the resistance to shunt resistance or series resistance, the current flowing capability in the moving coil is increased and decreased due to the rapid increasing in the current in the coil. Due to rapid decrease in the current in the coil, what happens means there is a deviation in the spring control. Okay, there is a deviation in the spring control and that changes the effect of instrument. So these are the three types of errors. Errors due to magnets, errors due to springs, the errors due to moving coil. Torque equation of PMMC instrument. So what are the things we need for deriving the torque equation of PMMC instrument? So we need the expression of deflection torque. What is the expression of deflection torque? So how can we derive this expression of deflection torque means? What is the main purpose of deflection torque? Deflection torque means the needle has to move from initial zeroth condition to a particular magnitude which the instrument is about to read. Deflection torque is required to move the needle from initial range to a particular maximum magnitude range. Let us say it is 5 amperes or 10 volts, whatever it may be the magnitude the instrument has to read. It has to move from the initial zeroth condition to reach that particular magnitude. Okay, so what is deflection torque involved? What are the parameters involved in deflection torque? Okay, so if we see number of turns in a coil, flux density with respect to the magnetic field, okay, and the length and horizontal, vertical and horizontal length of the conductor and the coil, and current flowing through that coil. So if we multiply all these things, these are the parameters involved with respect to the deflection torque. So that is what I exercised with respect to the parameter of deflection torque. Deflection torque T suffix T is equal to, okay, N in the sense number of turns in a coil into B in the sense flux density into L, length and diameter with respect to the conductor or with respect to the coil, and current flowing in the coil. So this is the expression with respect to the deflection torque. Okay, that means what are the parameters involved to create the deflection torque? Okay, we need a coil, we need certain amount of current, we need the flux density. So that's why I exercised all those parameters in the torque equation. Okay, that torque equation is analyzed with respect to G. G is nothing but a constant. G is equal to number of turns in a particular coil into flux density in the air gap with respect to the length and vertical sides of the diameter and length and diameter. Okay, so this is expression from the expression 2. I analyzed a constant, that is G. Okay, so and we also analyzed the expression of controlling torque in previous explanation. What is the controlling torque? Controlling torque is nothing but controlling torque is equal to deflection torque. Okay, deflection torque is proportional to deflection torque T suffix D is proportional to theta. Okay, deflection torque T suffix D is equal to T suffix C. In that case, controlling torque T suffix C is equal to K into theta, where K is nothing but constant. Okay, that's how we got this thing. That's how we got this thing. Controlling torque is equal to K into theta, where controlling torque is equal to deflecting torque. Okay, the torque exercised by the spring, that is restoring torque. The restoring torque exercised by the spring has to be equal to the deflection torque. As deflection torque is proportional to theta, controlling torque is equal to K into theta, where K is nothing but spring constant. Okay, K is nothing but spring constant. Okay, K is nothing but spring constant. K is nothing but spring constant. So that's what we did. We know controlling torque is equal to deflection torque. So this is the expression of controlling torque, and this is the expression with respect to deflection torque. Okay, this is the expression with respect to. So if we substitute G is equal to NBLD here, so deflection torque T suffix D is equal to G into I. Okay, controlling torque is equal to deflection torque at the end. By substituting the values, controlling torque is equal to K into theta, deflection torque is equal to G into I. So what is the angle of deflection? What is theta in the end? Final angle of deflection theta is equal to J divided by K, whereas current I is equal to K spring constant divided by constant G into theta. So this is the expression of this is the expression with respect to the angle of deflection, and this is the expression angle of deflection theta, and this is the expression of current flowing in the coil of PMMC instrument. Okay, so from the above expression, what we said, the deflection torque is proportional to the current flowing in the coil. So this is one of the important note. Okay, so here in today's class we discussed about the working animation of PMMC instruments. We analyzed the torque equation of PMMC instrument, and next we analyzed about the errors of PMMC instruments with respect to magnetic springs and moving coils. And last small thing is remained, that is advantages of PMMC instruments. What is the main advantages of PMMC instruments? Major advantage is here, deflection torque is proportional to T suffix D. Deflection torque is proportional to angle of deflection. That makes the working scale quite uniform. Scale in PMMC instrument is uniform. Okay, so it is correct, uniform in the sense, the scale, if we see the segmented scale, it is correctly divided, exactly divided, uniformly divided. Okay, and second most advantage is here, the power consumption is very, very less. Okay, with respect to the accuracy point of view also, because of the high torque weight ratio which is created with respect to the controlling springs of restoring torque, so the PMMC instrument create quite accuracy, and we can also improve the range of the PMMC instrument by connecting multiple series and shunt resistances with respect to the coil. Already exists in a coil ki oka type of resistance untundi. By connecting the multiple resistances, shunt resistance and series resistance, we can improve the range of the particular ammeters and voltmeters. Okay, and second most important thing is we are using permanent magnets, and that creates a high stationary magnetic field. So there are certain amount of drawbacks also. So we are using permanent magnet moving coil instrument for the measurement of DC current as DC ammeter, and for measurement of DC voltage as for DC voltmeter. Okay, so this instrument is used only for DC. We can't use that for AC, because if we use this for AC, there is a rapid varying in the torque, and the pointer cannot allow that type of fast reversal. Okay, that's why PMMC instrument can't be used for AC. And second thing is cost of the permanent magnet moving coil is very, very high when compared to the other instruments, because of this particular high magnetic materials and other coils and all, that creates the cost quite high. And second thing is moving coil itself provided with respect to the magnetic damping. So this also we discussed with respect to the damping torque. Okay, so this is about in today's class. So thank you everyone, thank you for your time.